Precious practice in the parlor. We sang churches in the dark. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Clark. Happy birthday to
I would if you let me.
Decided, due to health reasons, that staying in the teepee is not a good idea. So I'm going now. See you. Don't want to be you.
The teepee. Well, it was rather wet. Very, very windy last night. There were lots of drips, and our sleeping bags got wet. Our mattresses got wet, and a thoroughly unpleasant night. But what an experience.
Do you wish you'd slept in the teepee last night?
My thoughts on the teepee are somewhat confused. Last night people were talking about throwing up in it, and the water drops and fires. It's my idea of hell. I'd rather sleep in Scooby any day of the week.
They came in just after 11 o'clock, or they were in the bar just after 11 o'clock, and one of the girls went surfing. And I said, well, I'll take care of this one, thinking, who's that weirdo? You know, so I walked in and went, all right, girls. Because he looked like a girl. To be honest, as soon as I said,
the back, definitely.
As soon as I said, all right, girls, I spotted who it was. And I was like, you know, I would have rather have had, you know, two random, you know.
Well, I still wish I'd had that.
Yeah, but we had to put up with it.
Oh, so it's a tosser, isn't it?
Just no, like no, genuinely, I said, all right, girls. And then walked up and saw it was, yeah, Loon with his loony hair. Loony hair, his ridiculous hair.
And that's tonight.
And that, well, that was before, yeah, that was, yeah.
Thank you very much.
One of the guests, the guy that brought the two sons with him today to Jimmy's party. The guy that brought the two sons with him today to Jimmy's party. Also from Leighton. I've seen very little of him because I came home too late and I think they'd already gone back again. So I haven't really met him. So he turned up at 9 o'clock yesterday morning, walked in the door, and obviously we've met him before at Clive and Kate's and he's been here as well. Yes. We talked about the pubs all night when we had dinner at Clive and Kate's. Oh, yeah. Did he? Oh, that is Phil.
Yes, that's Phil.
So he turned up and I was like,
hang on,
you might want to
be careful. You think you're on film?
No. Phil, that bastard. Northern wanker. No. So he turned up and he walked in the door and it was like, oh, I've seen your age, how you doing? Chatting away. And,
Is this at 9 o'clock in the morning?
I said, do you want a coffee? He said, no, I've got to go. And 15 minutes later, we're still talking. So I said, are you sure you don't want that coffee? He said, no, I've got to go. But he was here about half an hour in total. I would have wanted a coffee, but I didn't get one. It wouldn't happen. But...
Is that the story?
No.
That was a really long way of getting to that story. Come on,
I'm starting to lose the...
Come on, then. Phil, turned it
What were we talking about before that?
Phil.
It was Phil and Tony Fairley.
Northern Wine Club.
Yes, that was it. Because then he said, whose is that van in there? And I said, oh, that's another one of Clive's mates. He went, all right. I said, I don't know his real name. As he said, it's Spider-Man. I suppose he's only known as Spider-Man here, so you wouldn't know that. But, Loon. His name's Loon. And what? David.
Oh, brilliant. What's that? I don't know.
Is he? I don't know.
He's got another one now, Jesus.
And so he said, well, what's he doing in that? Is that him? That's
Are
David.
You talking into the camera?
No,
you were doing?
No, I'm not paying attention to
you. Oh, Loon, put it away.
He said, that's David's. He said, where on earth did he get that? And I said, that
what,
he
David?
Bought it off someone famous, I think. And I couldn't remember who it was. And eventually, I remembered, it was Jimmy Savile.
Yes.
And he went, of course it was. He's one of our mates. We used to go jogging with him or something.
Yeah.
From David, Phil,
Jamie, and me, Alex.
Me, Jamie, Alex.
Yeah, you're Alex, yeah.
And who next? Called Clive. This donkey called Clive.
Is that because he's a bit of an ass?
Yeah.
I'm known as Donkey Head to my New Zealand family, and lovingly today I've been given this donkey.
By whom?
By it was either Alex or James.
Yeah.
But, this one.
Oh, James then, Jamie, which is very nice. So he bought it for me specially because he's heard about
your
my.
Donkey head?
Why are you called Donkey Head?
It was just, I don't know, just.
There must be a reason.
There was a story behind it.
Well, it wasn't why it was a donkey there, I don't think. It was just a little 3-year-old with Uncle Clive, and we were messing about, and I did something stupid, and he turned around and said, oh, Uncle Clive, you're a donkey head, isn't and it just stuck.
Is that a.
With 7 boxes of Nibble Time nuts. All day to the 1st of December.
Are they? What a git!
Cheese and bacon, tomato, hot and spicy, and barbecue.
I think you should open one for us to try them.
Really? They are awful. C-A-L-T-C.
Chatlads.
Right. Old Trafford, brackets, because Leeds are shite. Cosmos.
That's a nightclub in Leeds.
All Bar One.
In
Bar
Leeds.
On Greek Street.
Zach's.
Oh, Leeds.
Which passport stamp are you proudest of? Kingston upon Hull.
Yay.
Where I saw how the really beautiful game should be played.
Yay.
He's got his South Leeds, one that you'd most like to have, and Guilty Travel Pleasure P. Anal, because that's where the posh birds live.
Panel.
He has written P.A. All I want is my chops.
Who is 50 today, I believe. Just to embarrass them there, the age, you know. His name is Clive, so we're going to sing happy birthday to him. Happy birthday,
hi, Clive. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.